So let's talk about this Yamcha comic. That's right, Dragon Ball Side Story, the case of being reincarnated as Yamcha, created by fan manga artist Dragon Garo Lee. And Dragon Garo Lee is actually really well known for the One Punch Man Dragon Ball manga mashup. And if you guys want me to cover that in the future, leave a comment down below and we'll talk about the One Punch Man and Dragon Ball mashup. But one thing about Dragon Garo Lee is, just like Toyotaro and Naho Oishi, this guy started out drawing manga as a fan and now has a job at Shueisha doing this Yamcha manga. So those of you out there who are artists, just believe in the dream, because you never know who could be watching. And it's another example of somebody who started out as a fan and is now working for Shueisha on real Dragon Ball manga. So let's take a look at part one of what's supposed to be a three-part series focused on, well, Yamcha, but not really. So our story begins with a college kid who, much like many of us, is obsessed with Dragon Ball. And he's reading in his phone about going to a Dragon Ball exhibit, and he dreams of one day having a girlfriend that likes Dragon Ball, like I'm sure a lot of you out there probably do as well. So him and his homie find this girl that has a really short skirt. He wants to chase after her to get a good look because he's a pervert. He slips on the stairwell and knocks himself out, and he wakes up in the body of Yamcha. Fantastic. And at first he's trying to figure out what's going on, and his reaction is very similar to the reaction that a lot of us would have. Why couldn't we have wound up in Goku or Vegeta's body instead? But then he realizes, wait a minute, is this a dream or not? What's really going on? And then he sees Bulma and he thinks, wait a second, I'm Yamcha, there may be some benefits here. And obviously, of course, he gets transported back into the body of Yamcha from way back at the beginning of Dragon Ball. And for a little while there, he's trying to figure out just what the hell is going on and how he wound up being inside the body of a fictional character. But because he has knowledge of the Dragon Ball series, he pretty much knows exactly what's going to happen. And he already knows that Goku's an alien. He already knows all of the twists and turns of Goku and the rest of the cast's life that the actual Yamcha had no idea about. And then he remembers, wait a minute, I'm Yamcha. That means I'm destined to become a punching bag for the vast majority of this series, and I'm gonna end up dying. But they have a really awesome panel here where he's like, can I just quit fighting? I know I'm not gonna win, which I think is fantastic, and I think it's one of those things where Dragon Garo Lee's really familiar with Yamcha, just like we are. But he decides that he's not gonna die. He decides that if he goes with Goku to train with the Turtle Hermit, with Master Roshi, he might be able to change the future. Because remember, Yamcha did not train with Roshi initially, like when Goku and Krillin did. But this time, if he did, maybe he would have a head start. And unfortunately, that means he's going to have to leave Bulma behind for a little while. Now, at this point, the story skips forward in time and goes to the arrival of Vegeta and Nappa, which I found to be a very interesting choice because I was wondering how Dragon Garo Lee was going to address the fact that Yamcha had his leg broken by Ten Shin Han in the 22nd tournament, but he just skimmed over it and was like, whatever. I guess that the natural course of events happened the way they did, I guess, but if Yamcha was training younger, maybe he could have beat Tien in that fight. Who really knows? But in this version of the story, although Vegeta still thought it would be fun to do one versus one, Z Fighter versus Cyberman, Yamcha in this version says he wants to fight them all at once. And as a result of this Yamcha being stronger, he was able to beat all six of them single-handedly. But then, in a scene of sheer desperation, all six of them, that's right, all six of them jumped on Yamcha, sacrificed themselves, blew themselves up at the exact same time, putting an end to Yamcha. But no, Yamcha actually survived. It'll take more than that to beat me. This is so awesome for Yamcha fans, yo. Fantastic stuff. So as a result of the impressive display of power and durability that Yamcha showed, Piccolo's wondering how the hell did he get so strong. And it looks like what happened, folks, at least the way it's being teased in the final page of this manga, is that Yamcha at some point went to Namek and had his power unlocked by the Grand Elder of Namek. And of course, he knew that because the kid who possessed Yamcha already knew the entire story of Dragon Ball, so he knew that this was possible. But that's the end of the first of three chapters of the Dragon Ball Side Story by manga artist Dragon Garo Lee. We are expecting the next chapter to come out early 2017, so that'll be a whole lot of fun to see where the story goes now that this, quote, Yamcha knows the fate of his character. And it's pretty cool, again, that Dragon Garo Lee was allowed to come in and do this. And it just goes to show that the Dragon Ball Shueisha Story Group is serious about expanding Dragon Ball. And although this is not the first of the Dragon Ball side mangas we've ever seen, it's definitely the first one that we've seen since the story group was established. And look forward to seeing what else they're going to give us. Thank you for watching. Let me know your thoughts on all this. I will talk to you guys later.